And would you be kind enough to welcome Tonja, Perdita, and Craig up to the stage now. Three University of Illinois Hall of Famers. Tonja, I'll start with you because the video started with you. 25 Big Ten individual and relay titles during an impressive career. What'd you do with all the medals? What'd you do with all the trophies? 25 is a big number now.
I was a team player. They're in a box in my mother's house. They're plaques, actually. They gave us plaques back then, way back then.
That's the joy of it, isn't it? It's the memories, not what the medals are, what the trophies are. What was it about your time at Illinois that has given you guidance, vision, passion for this next phase, the post-athletic phase of your life? What lessons did you learn?
You know, I can't imagine from how I grew up that I would, you know, end up at a place like Illinois and have the kind of experiences that I had. I mean, I really grew within the first 6 months. It was pretty fascinating what I learned and what the world was really like, which was a lot different than my hometown in Dayton, Ohio, and my community. So it was just a blessing to be able to be in that environment and learn so much academically and as a student athlete. And, you know, Champaign is really a great city. And I don't think people really realize that and how much there is to do in that little small town. And, you know, all the student athletes rile together. And, you know, we just had so much fun. It was four really, really great years.
Craig, can you talk about your time in Champaign-Urbana and your thoughts on as you arrived and what it meant to you to be on the campus and have the impact that you had knowing the place so well?
Well, Mike, thank you. And I'm an honor to be on the stage with these two lovely ladies, and both of them Olympians. And Tonja was not only a great athlete for the University of Illinois herself, but when I've done color analyst work for the Big Ten Network, I got to cover her coaching at the University of Illinois, and she was the coach of the year 1 year, and she built that program back to strength. So Tonja, you're not only a Hall of Famer as an athlete, you're a Hall of Famer as a coach.
Okay? Thank you very much, Craig.
Mike, when I got there to University of Illinois in 1973, I'm sitting next to Dick Butkus out there, and the university, and I tell it like it is, so if any of you can't handle it, be prepared, fasten the seatbelt, but we were recovering from the slush fund scandal back in the 1960s. And we hadn't signed a state champion in a long time. And when I could have gone anywhere in the country, and when I announced to people that I was gonna stay in state, and I was gonna stake my future with the orange and blue, and prove to them that the great athletes in Illinois did not have to leave the state, they didn't have to go to California, they didn't have to go to Michigan, they didn't have to go to Florida or Tennessee, or Texas, they could stay right here in the state of Illinois and not only get a great education, but pursue excellence as an athletics. And I went there, and it took a while, and my goal wasn't just to achieve personal achievements, my goal was to achieve team achievements. And by the time I was a senior, our team in cross country finished fifth in the country and third in track, okay? And one last thing is that the program in track and cross country, we were the number three sport at Illinois for those 4 years. Every school has a number three sport behind basketball and football, mm-hmm. All right?
Right.
We were
right.
Number three, and to show you how much it was, we hosted the NCAA championships my senior year. And so I got to run my last race as an Illini in the NCAA championships in Memorial Stadium. And there was no greater honor than that. So that kind of sums up what I feel.
And that was in 1977. And while Craig was so kind to point out the team accomplishments and how he cherishes those, I do want to point out that Craig is still, 40 years later, the only American man to win world cross-country championship, doing it twice. So credit to you, 40 years later, for being the only American man to do that. Well, I'll cross the border to the first Canadian woman to ever win a medal at the World Championships, winning two World Championships in the 100-meter hurdles. So, Perdita, you bring a great and unique and special pride to it. Talk about how your experience was as you came over from Canada and then really fell in love with the campus and the athletic department there and your track teammates as well.
Yeah, it's surreal being here tonight because one of the reasons I came to school is because of Tonja Buford-Bailey. Just studying the media guide when Gary Winkler mailed it to my house in Pickering, Ontario, and just seeing what she had accomplished and thought, gosh, if I could accomplish a percentage of that. I was different though, because I was a very reluctant athlete. My mom is here tonight in the audience, and so is my stepdad. But yes. And in the 10 years that I lived in Champaign, my mom was only able to come up once, and that was for my graduation in 2004. And this is her second time in Illinois in 10 years, and she couldn't miss this. So thank you, Mom, for being here. My mom is, she immigrated to Canada when she was a teenager, and she had me there, so I was her first child born in Canada. So she knew nothing about organized sport or athletics. And here she has this little child who is tearing up the track, right? And when we started getting scholarship offers from all across the states, I started turning them down. And so in May of 1999, when Gary Winkler, the head coach of track, called me, and I was just getting inundated with requests, I was like, I want all these people to stop calling me. So I turned down Gary Winkler. Who does that? And for me, when I got my senses together that summer, and my mom sat me down and she said, Perdit, this is an opportunity. Honey, I don't know how I'm going to pay for you and your siblings to go to school. You have to take this. And it was scary because when we got the scholarship offers, they said like $25,000. And my mom thought we had to pay for it. I was like, no, they've given that to us, Mama. And so when you guys talk about how Illinois has really enriched your life, I can tell you it has changed the trajectory of my life. And yeah. And so when young Canadian women, young Canadian athletes say that I have inspired them, I know that I stand on the shoulders of Tonja Buford-Bailey, I stand on the shoulders of Gary Winkler and all the athletes that have walked the hallways of the University of Illinois, and I'm forever grateful for that. So thank you.
And as we wrap up with these three Hall of Fame track athletes, I'll ask you if you can, in one sentence, to put into words what this honor means to each of you. Craig, I'll start with you.
When I came to the University of Illinois and I walked around campus, I saw names on buildings, I saw names on stadiums, I saw names on gyms, and many of those names are in this class tonight. And so it makes me so thrilled to be here, to be a part of that first group. I have a teammate out there that's made two Olympic teams, and he'll probably be in next year, and I'll be out there supporting him. Really, one of the most special moments for me of being at the University of Illinois was my teammates. I never joined a fraternity. I never had to. They are here tonight. There's like 15 people here tonight from my team. The Illini 8, stand up. Stand up, please.
Stand over there, guys. There they are.
Right there. These guys, you know, I would take a bullet for them, and they would take a bullet for me. Was our team successful because we were close, or were we close because we were successful? You be the judge. But when you go to a school and college, you want to get an education, you want to improve as an athlete, but by God, I hope you can have teammates like I did that'll be with you for the rest of your life, okay?
Perdita,
yeah.
In a shorter sentence than Craig's, maybe.
That'll be easy.
Nah, you know what? You're Hall of Famers. You're all in charge. Do whatever the heck you want.
You know what? I'll be quick. I will say the one word that comes to mind for me is the word gratitude or grateful. It's been I graduated in 2004, so it's been 13 years, and I still long for the South Farms. I still long for the Armory. I still long for 300 repeats where we're puking, and I miss that. And all of you who have been an athlete at the University of Illinois, you understand that that fraternity, that sorority, that community is probably impossible for us to recreate in our lives now. But I am so grateful to be connected, and I want to say quickly to Josh, thank you for this. I can say I feel reconnected. I feel re-energized. I feel like I know what's going on. And I'm not alone. We've been saying this as alumni. So this is amazing. And so I know that for me, I'm just one person. But together, look at what we've done. Look at what we've accomplished. And there is so much more to come. And I'm just so grateful for this night and everything that Illinois has meant to me.
Tonja?
You know, in one word, I would just say empowerment. You know, when I left Dayton, Ohio in 1989, I'm telling my age, you know, I was kind of shy and had no idea what, you know, was out there in the world. And I tell you, 4 years later, I felt like I could conquer the world, and I still feel that way. And that was from those 4 to 5 years that I spent in Champaign, and then the next 4 to 5 years after. And the 10 years that I coached there, there's no way I would be where I'm today if it wasn't for U of I.
Ladies and gentlemen, Hall of Famers, Tonja Buford-Bailey, Perdita Felicien, and Craig Virgin, congratulations all.